Writing a scientific paper involves paraphrasing someone else's findings. Some novice authors find the process of describing the work of others challenging. Hi, I'm Kieran McKee, and in this video, I'll be talking about how to paraphrase and provide some tips that may help you. Paraphrasing simply means putting someone else's ideas into your own words. The alternative is quoting, in which you restate someone's exact words and put them in quotation marks. But quotations are not typically used in scientific papers. Instead, source information is restated in a way that avoids wording that is too similar to the original text. If you repeat what the source said with only minor changes in diction, you could be accused of plagiarism. Let's look at some examples. Here is an original text written by Neubauer, 2008. Despite the higher mineral content of tidal freshwater marsh soils, this ability of organic matter to effectively hold water and air in interstitial spaces suggests that organic matter is responsible for 62% of marsh accretion, with the remaining 38% from mineral contributions. We want to paraphrase this. A poor approach would be to simply substitute some of the words with synonyms, but fail to change the sentence structure or emphasis, as I've done here. The altered wording is in red. Although I've replaced some of the terms with synonyms, the sentence is still too close to the original phrasing. Also, a key technical term, accretion, has been replaced with a more general term, accumulation. Here is a better way to paraphrase the same text. Research conducted in tidal freshwater marshes with a higher mineral soil content suggests that organic matter, through its effect on water and air-filled pore spaces in wetland soils, can account for almost two-thirds of marsh vertical accretion. Neubauer, 2008. First, I've presented the information in a slightly different order than in the original, but restructured the sentence so that it still conveys the importance of organic matter to the process of accretion. I've introduced the information with the key phrase, "research conducted in tidal freshwater marshes," which tells the reader that I am going to describe previous research. I've retained the key technical term accretion and substituted interstitial spaces with pore spaces. Instead of repeating the exact percentages for organic and mineral inputs, I've restated the organic contribution in more general terms. Of course, if it's important for the reader to know exact percentages, then you should provide them. Here's another example from McKee et al., 2007. The original text states, "The Caribbean region is an important reservoir of mangrove peat with deposits up to 10 meters thick. Our work showed that removal of mangrove vegetation would stop soil accretion while decomposition, physical compaction, and erosion processes continue, ultimately leading to submergence and land loss." Here is one way to paraphrase this information. "Research conducted in mangrove systems in the Caribbean region showed that removal of the mangrove vegetation would alter the balance among the processes controlling vertical soil development, thereby threatening an important reservoir of peat." Here's another way. "Removal of mangrove vegetation in peat-forming settings, such as the Caribbean region, is thought to halt soil accretion and increase vulnerability to submergence by rising sea level." McKee et al., 2007. Summarizing is related to but different from paraphrasing. Paraphrasing involves restating a specific passage to convey an idea in your own words. Summarizing involves distilling a longer passage or several passages to make a broader point. For example, I can combine the two previous sources and write a more general summary like this. "Many coastal ecosystems, including marshes and mangroves, are dependent upon the presence of vegetation and organic matter inputs to soil accretion to avoid submergence during sea level rise." McKee et al., 2007, Neubauer, 2008. In this example, the two original passages are used to make a broader point about the importance of vegetation to keeping pace with sea level rise. Here are a few tips to avoid plagiarism when paraphrasing. When taking notes from the literature, always identify text that is a direct quote with quotation marks so that you don't confuse the original wording with your paraphrase. Any text with phrases or sentences identical to the source should be set off with quotation marks and a citation. Read the source information first and then try to put it into your own words without looking at it. Every idea, point, conclusion, or implication that is not yours should have a citation. Even reporting an idea from your own previous work requires a citation. Always paraphrase the original source of information, not a secondary source such as a review paper. Use AI tools such as ChatGPT sparingly to help you paraphrase. You should instead use AI tools to help you learn how to paraphrase effectively. If you are unsure about your paraphrasing, use a plagiarism checker to make sure your text is not too similar to published work. To learn how to paraphrase, you need to practice. Select some papers in your field and try to reword specific passages. See if you can come up with at least three paraphrases for each passage. Eventually, paraphrasing will become second nature. Thanks for watching, and please leave a comment or like if you found this information helpful.